new in this area. Do you happen to have any tips?
Well, maybe I do. But why don't you ask one of your thousand husbands, coal woman? What? I have nothing to say to you. Now, shove off.
Thousand husbands? Are you always this friendly?
Of course. Especially to people of your kind. Now, excuse me. I have to go.
Huh. Well, I never. So here's some of my thousand husbands, I guess. Omaric? Isn't he the one I just talked to?
Watch yourself.
Yeah.
The streets aren't safe this time of the day.
Wash?
Huh? What do you want?
That's a pretty cool bow. Jail.
Walk blessed.
Thank you.
Well, that's just how he is, old. He's talking rot.
Talking rot.
That's just how it is. Everything was better in the old days.
Sure it was. The drunken bee. Oh my god, they just stood up on... Why'd they do that?
The ancient world seemed newborn in his eyes.
Did you hear
the
Huh? What do you want?
That's not how you use that thing. There you go.
Malphas's blessings.
Oh, thank you. She's still up there, though. I'm new to the area. Is there any interesting places around? Is this a custom of yours?
Interesting in terms of skullduggery and adventuring, you mean?
Duggery. Mm. Skullduggery.
There's the Three River Watch further north.
Been there.
An abandoned trading post. You've probably been there already. And then there's a Pyrean ruin on the lake down south. Sharoth, or whatever they call it. There are lots of undead around, though. At least, according to the hunter, Matumiao. And, of course, there's Castle Goldfirth on the outmost cliff in the southwest. But I'd give that a wide berth if I were you.
Hmm. I'll probably give it a couple levels. What's the story behind that castle?
Ah, well, I only know the rumors, and they're as old as my grandfather. Apparently, the castle belonged to a count who ruled over the Suncoast some centuries ago and fell victim to some sort of tragedy. Bottom line, the castle is dangerous and brimming with ghosts.
Ghosts?
And as much as I'd like to dismiss that as nonsense, lots of travelers come here telling us about these strange noises they heard near the castle at night. As I said, I'd give it a wide berth.
Hmm. I'll think about it.
Which means I can't wait to go there, doesn't it? Pray to Melfast for protection, then. You'll need it.
Hmm. There you go. Oh, we can gamble? How much money do I even have? Not that much. Should sit down. I'm gonna gamble with myself. The gaming table is currently unoccupied. Come back in the evening or night to play. How does it know? I can't. How do I see? Okay. 3:21 p.m. Well, you told me to sit down and it was for nothing. Oh, I want cabbage stew.
To the stars in the sky, and we stay behind.
Hi.
Hmm? Is it important?
No idea.
Well, that's just how he is. Always talking much.
Who's that?
Teolora Renthiel has returned after all these years. Malphas truly smiles upon us.
What the hell is that? Lyrical gushes and other fluids. A guide to Prince Smith's poems. It's a steal, though. I can't take it. I want books you don't understand.
Oh. Guy's
upset about something. Oh, she's a little creepy, huh? Where do the songs you sing come from?
It depends. Some of them are ancient Enderalian traditions. Some have been written by famous bards, and some of them I've collected through my journeys.
Hmm. May I wish for a specific song?
What would you like to hear?
Okay. Song of the Last Sunset, Vetyrs, Wayward Wanderer, Aged Man and Whisper Wood. Do you have something that doesn't start with the name The Song of the? Wild Mages, Lost Ones, Black Guardian, Crimson's. Okay, Wild Mages.
Sure.
Malfas's blessings.
Shivering hands and delirious eyes, brittle voices and maniac minds, they roam across the land.
That was a creepy shadow.
Terror and dismay. Walls of fire and arrows of ice. Hmm? Before you can blink, huh? They have slaughtered you twice. Death is their companion.
You people are creepy, meow. I have that.
Malfas's light has never shone on their face.
Malfas's blessings.
The anarchist fever has clouded their
Can I just come back here with you? Because...
Walk blessed.
Want something to drink? What have you got?
Oh, a bit of this and that. The roast rabbit is really good. Take a look for yourself.
Roast rabbit is not a drink. Archaic vegan soup. Satiates for 570 seconds. Long dated health regeneration. The higher your health score, the more health will be regenerated to you. Your troubled brain.
Wild and free. Wicked wayward wizards, if they're going to
I'll take baked potatoes.
You'll soon be crazy too. If the magic
safe travels
up in your head, okay. And your spirit is filled with frenzy and dread. Don't wait or soon. All help will be. The journey to the water you must take, or else the fever will deform your shape. A monster you will be, the frightful blue death. Malfas's life.
Haha. Health potion rancid. Old iron arrows. A petty soul gem. What happened? Oh, I got extra from the small stash underneath, I guess. Potion of protection from magic.
On their face. The anarchist fever has clouded their troubled brains.
All right, now.
Mages wild and free.
If I cook this, okay. You may cook foodstuffs to make it more effective. For cooking, you will need several ingredients, e.g. basic foodstuffs or salt. Cooked food satiates you longer and regenerates more health.
Wicked wayward wizards, if they're pointing.
So roasted pheasant. Yes.
Fingers at you, you'll
okay.
Soon be
roasted
crazy
rabbit's foot.
Too.
Well, that's just how he is. Always talking about.
Oh, I'm getting experience by doing this? A small amount, but yeah, roasted wolf meat. Oh, this is the longest yet, I think. 700 seconds. That's all we have, or I need salt or something.
Oh, well.
just got a new delivery of ale. Anyone?
Hopefully you don't want the ale and not the wine. Hi. Don't talk much, do you?
I really need that new herbal essence for my hair.
I don't talk much. That's a locked door. Ooh, a wood distraction. But I can't sneak for crap. At least not yet. The sun slowly sinks in its nocturne. Hello.
Just where did I put it?
You're leaving our world, rising up high.
Vin, a geographical overview.
Well, that's just how it is.
Cool. Arcanist of the Second Signet. It's an interesting font. Well, I really gotta read this. It's my next let's read.
Didn't
take it. Blood Moon. Huh. Not a book. I dreamt of the Blood Moon. Sorrowfully, he sat on his majestic throne amidst the firmament, overseeing the desolate countryside with tear-filled eyes. The soft red glow with which he covered fields and meadows as the layer out would cover a pale child, and the crimson blanket of velvet and oblivion bedewed my soul like the shadows of those long, pale trees, their bleak faces forever in defiance of the endless breeze. I feel as if a part of me died the moment I beheld the unnatural moonlight dying away on the ground. This foreignness in the familiar, this unfounded melancholia. Was it melancholia? I think it's melancholia. It makes sense. This yearning for places far away, for impossible architecture, for all things unhuman and incomprehensible, for things threatening to erase my sanity. All of this only because of the moon. The moon who sat up there as if he were an age-old child, sallow and pale like a long-forgotten corpse. I dreamt of the Blood Moon. Sounds like a lycanthropy kind of thing.
Alone in the dark, our lives will be lacking.
Hello. Energized water from Inodan. Regenerates 4 mana for 3 seconds. That's cool. More arrows. That's good.
The glow of your spark.
Sweet. Got a book. Got a book. Is that it?
This is where your path ends.
That door is locked. Yeah,
I just don't see the fucking point.
I beg your pardon.
Men, that's just how they are.
What, cursing? I thought he was vaping. Oh. Is that... Oh, that's, not smoke. That's... What do you call it? It's water spray.
Huh. Honest, aren't you? Well, I hope your name is on the register. Last thing Enderal needs right now are more wild mages.
I don't think I'm on a register. Oh, wait a second. I didn't want to go that way. Rivervale discovered now. Haven't they been in it already? Ark? Hey! That's his friend. Hello. Alfrid.
Who are you?
Just a traveler. You are Alfrid, right? The childhood friend of a man named Yero?
Yero, this is about his death, isn't it? The rampage.
You've heard about it?
Of course, who hasn't? Yero was one of us, after all. It is terrible. Simply terrible. You want to hear an old man's opinion, though? I always expected that something like this would happen. Malthus, forgive me for talking about a keeper like that, but it's the truth.
You mean you saw it coming? How?
Hard to explain, really. Come on, let's find somewhere to sit. It'll be easier to talk that way.
Okay. Lay it on. Oh, right here. Okay.
Well, Yero. Yero. That's quite a subject, you know. You were right when you said we were best friends. Our fathers knew each other. For as long as I can remember, Yero and I were getting into trouble together. At least, until his mother died.
Not of old age, I assume?
No. Bandits killed her in broad daylight on Penny Road. Today these incidents are common, but not back then. The road was considered safe. Very safe. She was on her way to Ark, accompanied by three other women, and they were set upon at the pass. None of them survived. Yero was shattered. I think the worst part was how his father went downhill after his wife's death.
That's really sad.
The fishery decayed, and the poor guy filled his days with boozing and sleeping. It changed Yero forever.
How, exactly?
Well, that's a good question. On the one hand, he became a man, despite his tender age. On the other hand, something inside him woke up, so to speak. A desire to make more of his life. Old Mother Jenica noticed it and took him under her wing. He learned how to read and write, and soon he knew all the holy verses by heart. When he didn't have to help his drunken father, he helped in the village as much as he could.
He transformed his grief into productivity. Sounds like a rather positive development.
Indeed, that's one way to look at it. It wasn't long before he was the jewel of the village, the striving young fisherman destined for great things, even though he was only on the path of a manufacturer. And then the inevitable happened. A keeper of the order came to Riverville to see the prodigy with his own eyes. And behold, in addition to Yero's ingenuity, he also had a slumbering magical talent. The keeper took him away, and a few months later, he started his novitiate. Since then, I've only seen him once or twice, as he rarely visited Riverville. I don't think he ever noticed how much that hurt me.
Is that uncommon for someone on the manufacturer's path to get a chance to become a keeper?
If one of the manufacturers makes it to Sergeant of the Guard, it's reason enough for a bard song. He must have been the first novice in centuries who was not of the sublime path. So yes, sir, it is uncommon. More than that.
So what did you mean by, I always suspected that something like this would happen?
Oh, it's hard to explain. I believe it was the way he was talking about his grand plans. How he wanted to make the world a better place. To become the greatest keeper since Lorem Waterblade. Underneath all this, there was an anger. An anger mixed with deep grief and disappointment. I don't think he was aware of it because he drew all his strength from that anger. The strength to do all this, to learn and to work day and night, but it frightened me, like the Blue Death. It slumbers inside the pathless mage who believes he can master magic without the Order's help. At first, it grants power, but then, one day, It bursts out in an unholy wave of destruction, turning him into one of the monsters in the old songs. Anyway, I'm just an old man. What do I know about these matters? Now let me go to sleep, my dame. All these memories are making me weary.
Well, you didn't look that old, but, thanks for your help.
Yes, of course.
Tell Jespar about Alfred's stories. Looks like he's actually gonna go in there. So where's this shrine? These roads really aren't safe. You have guards all over the place. Should I question him some more? No, he went to sleep right away. A pillow, look at that. The Golden House. I don't think this. Your lock picking abilities are too low for this lock. You need to unlock the appropriate memories beforehand. Yeah, the level up screen, right? Need food, you know? Things attack me a lot. Can I make anything else? Yeah, I feel bad. I'm gonna steal his frickin' 5 gold. See if I can make anything else with the stuff I just took? No. I probably need salt. Look. Sausages. Seriously, we got sausages. Ooh, nice. I like sausages. Peaceweed? Enderalian sugar braid. What's an Enderalian sugar braid? Satiates for 4. Okay. It's a sweet roll. 480 seconds. We got some food now. Feel like I can take on the world. Alright, let's look at this, because find the place described by the poem. It's not telling me where that is. Behind a house. But what house? And how far behind? Find the use of the key. Voice in the water. This one shows us. I haven't been over there yet. Alright. These people are tired.
Oh shit. I have to remember that.
Men, that's just how they are.
10 pennies for a sack of grain. Damn these farmers.
Oh, we got a marketplace here.
Yeah, that should be it.
Well, comes a point when you just have to live with it.
Uh-huh. Hail. Are your wares for sale?
No, I just put them out for you to look at. Tell me what you need, and be quick about it.
Friendly. Oh, we got blueprints for stuff. We can make stuff. Alright, so this is all crafting and stuff like that. Oh yeah, that's, we can greatly afford that, yeah.
Walk blessed.
Thanks.
A foreigner, huh? What a surprise.
Indeed.
I really need that new herbal essence for my hair.
Greetings.
Yes?
No. Interact with the notice board. Bounty missions and petitions are announced on this notice board. Search for a bounty post? Alright. Wanted in Riverville? Read the context. The notice board to receive bounty missions. The pathless one, Redrick Borenstone, is wanted for multiple frauds and aggravated robbery. He is sturdy, has blue eyes and a blonde beard. He is said to be extremely dangerous, so proceed with caution. There are 180 Enderalian pennies issued for his death. I don't think I'm ready for this yet. Give me a few levels.
You're not from around here, are you? I know that accent.
You heard me talking to myself, huh?
Have you heard? Nerim has been united again. But their leader must be a monster. They say he's crucifying priests and burning down temples. I'm not surprised that the gods have turned their backs on them.
What do we have here? Books? And alchemy? Oh, you look insane.
Oh.
You also sound insane. Are you okay, madame?
Oh. I sense vibrations. Horrible, bad vibrations. Oh, yes, I feel them very strongly.
Sounds like a personal problem. Bad vibrations?
Oh, yes. Something peculiar surrounds you.
It's called clothes.
Your aura! Oh, by Malthus, no!
Oh, don't be so dramatic. What about it?
It is indigo blue, the color of the dying.
Oh.
It must be a magical anomaly, but still, that doesn't bode well.
Yeah, I have to take that stuff for my fever.
You're lucky. The stars are on your side.
Are they?
I, just like you, find myself in deep trouble. And maybe we can help each other.
You seem like someone who needs a lot of help. How can you help me?
I have a special object in stock. A skull.
Why would I want that?
According to the legends, it comes from the midst of the Kiran Desert. And us Arcanists refer to it as the Master Skull. It is a risky experiment. But at midnight, if you balance the skull on your head for one full hour, it might help to reharmonize your aura. Maybe.
Look, if you want me to help you, I want something useful in return, not some skull.
Oh, such distrust in the cosmic powers. Well, A horse can only be led to the water. The drinking has to be done by the horse itself. If it's coin you're after, you shall have it. A couple of days ago, something precious was stolen from me. My beauty potion. And until yesterday, I was in the dark as to who took it. A vision has shed light onto the matter.
A vision, huh?
It was an aura thief.
Oh, okay. An aura thief?
Yes. Old beings from past times, way before the Pyreans. For common eyes, they are invisible, but we, spiritually gifted, can see them.
Okay.
Aura thieves only have one reason for existence, and that is to disrupt harmony by playing horrible pranks on innocent people, such as the theft of my potion.
How can you be sure it wasn't a rainbow-colored unicorn who stole it?
Unicorns are fairy tales, you should know that. It was an aura thief. I can feel that deep within me.
So, did you say it stole your beauty potion?
Yes! Its essence is fresh water directly from the sources of Inodan. A real rarity, you see. But it is as potent as it is exquisite. To those who drink it regularly, the potion grants both an otherworldly allure, as well as it completely stops natural aging. And before you ask, yes, only through the elixir was I able to maintain my youthful beauty over all these years.
Such as it is, I guess. Alright, I will see if I can find your potion. Any ideas where I should start looking?
I have a suspicion. Yesterday, when I danced at the river, I heard a voice out of nowhere whispering right into my ear. And it only said 6 words. Find me in the Clearwater Cave. I'm sure it was the potion who spoke to me, but I'm too old to go exploring old caves like this one on my own. Which is sad, since said cave is only a few minutes' march from the village. It's an abandoned mine just up the hill that leads to the pass. Go there and find my potion, and I will reward you most generously.
Bad vibrations.
That's just how they are.
If I'm ready for any of this stuff.
Greetings.
So the potion talked to you. Okay, could I see your wares then?
Yes, of course.
Crafting books, okay. Yes. I want to definitely learn about alchemy and probably enchantment as well. But, not just yet. Health flux potion. Save my money for now.
Farewell.